I just want to be where you are, dwelling daily in your presence.
Shalom. Welcome to Divine Marriage Program. We are grateful to God for giving us another chance to come to you through this program. Welcome. It's time now to discuss about marriage. Divine Marriage Program comes to you every week, Monday to Friday, and we are grateful to God. Thank you for being there for us. You have been supportive, and your support has been overwhelming, and we thank God, both local and international support. We give praise to God for this wonderful time. Welcome. Let us know where you are tuned in from, and then you are free to share this broadcast with your friends on Facebook, and you can also host watch parties with your friends, and you're going to be blessed in the name of Jesus. Welcome, and God bless you for being for us.
Amen.
We are grateful to God, and we thank Him for this wonders that He is doing in marriage. Welcome. My name is Apostle Domiziano Mwenda. We are together with my wife, Pastor Florida Mwenda. We all come from Life Equipping and Restoration Ministry, the King's House, Muranga Town. Muranga is in Central Kenya, East Africa. Welcome and God bless you. Please let us know where you are tuned in from and what this program is doing in your life. Welcome your invite your friends, and also let them come on board. It is time to discuss about marriage, and we are privileged this period to come to you on daily basis, Monday to Friday. So it's a rare thing, but embrace it at this time, and let us continue establishing foundations of happy marriage. And I believe when you follow the instructions that we are receiving daily, you are going to be happy. As many people desire a happy family, we desire to have a marriage that is good, but most of us are not willing to pay the price. Some of us are not willing to pay the price. So it will cost you something. It will not just come. You have to pay a price. You have to commit yourself. You must give yourself a chance to work out that marriage relationship. If you don't work out that marriage relationship, it will not give you what you want. We were talking last week and even this week, we are talking about burnouts and we have understood what is really causing burnouts in marriage, and we need to come out of that. Yesterday we said we shall just give you a recap how to avoid. We said you maintain your worship, be content, committed to worship, be committed to worship life. And when we are committed to worship life, you will be able to serve God wholeheartedly, be prayerful, work out your salvation with fear and trembling. When you do all those things and you are committed to fellowship, especially even couples fellowship, then I want to guarantee you, you have added a lot of value in your marriage. Then be committed to provide the needs of the other partner. Don't force your partner to malfunction by failing to give the needs that this person needs to be able to function. Then maintain marital covenant. That is a very key thing. You enter into covenant, maintain that marital covenant. It will give you a lot of benefits when you maintain it. Refuse to give up on your spouse. Refuse.
Yeah.
You say again, I keep reminding you, a happy marriage is a marriage between two imperfect people. Not perfect people. You don't get a perfect partner the way you are thinking.
Mm-hmm.
You get imperfect, but you love this partner in a perfect way. So what we are committed to do is to love the partner that God has given unto us in a perfect way. There is no perfect people, but they are perfect. There is perfect love. This perfect love is given to us by God. He has poured it in our hearts. So we are able to love. And when we are able to love, we change the lives of others. Love has the power to change lives. So welcome and bold. And God bless you. And let us know where you are tuned in from. And we will be glad. Let us know where you are tuned in from. Mm-hmm. And what this program is doing in your marriage life. Refuse to give up on your spouse.
Yeah.
Fulfill your marital responsibilities. All your duties.
Mm.
Fulfill them. And this, you do not give a space to the evil to come. Water your marriage so that your marriage will remain to be green. When you work out your marriage, your wife remains green, your husband remains green. There is no green aperture anywhere. Yours remain green.
Yeah.
So work it out. If you don't work it out, you start searching for greener aperture.
Yeah.
And riches. Mm-hmm. A mistake.
Mm-hmm.
If the people are searching, they need to come around you and see how green is your patch. Not you.
Mm-hmm.
Not you. You need to work out that marriage relationship. Don't be a lone ranger in marriage. It's dangerous. Don't be a lone ranger in marriage. Don't walk this journey of marriage alone. Don't be a lone ranger. Have mentors.
Mm-hmm.
People you can pour your heart to, people that you can talk to and tell them what is happening, and they can help you. You see, mentorship is very key, even in marriage, not only in other areas. In marriage, it's very important. Take time out from the work, time to time. Don't overwork. Don't do a lot excess work. Remember, burns from the work can also bring. Burnouts from the works can also bring it into marriage. So use those vacations when you have gone out or when you are free, use it with your family. And this will be a time to build home and you will be happy when this is happening. Have retreats with your spouse. Make sure that you can go out and visit some places.
Mm-hmm.
And this is going to be very useful. And then cultivate the pattern of relaxation that you can relax. You can have time to relax. And this is very important. You engage yourself in recreational activities. And that is nice for you. Then live your own life. That's key.
Mm-hmm.
Live your own life. Don't live to prove a point to somebody. Live your own life. Live your own life. Be yourself. Run your race.
Mm-hmm.
There is your marriage. There is somebody's marriage. There is your husband, there is somebody's husband.
Mm-hmm.
There is your wife and somebody's wife. Stop comparing your wife with someone else's wife. Stop comparing your husband with someone else's husband.
Amen.
We are unique, mm-hmm. created in a different way.
Yeah.
My marriage is not your marriage.
Mm-hmm.
That is not your marriage.
Yeah.
You have your own. Your wife is different from mine. And my family is different from your family. So please live your own life and you enjoy it your own way.
Mm-hmm.
Make yours enjoyable, yourself, in your own way. And I want to say, when you follow these things, you will not burn out. You will not lose that interest. You will not feel like you are disinterested or you are lost desire. You will not fade. You will not even faint. You will continue to be strong. And we are going to be lifted up. And God is going to bless us. Tonight we have a very interesting topic. And I would like to look at it keenly. And I believe it will be a blessing to you. How you become suitable or complementary. Or you become somebody who complements your own wife, your own husband.
Mm-hmm.
The suitability in marriage. Are you feeling that something is wrong, that you're not suitable? Are you feeling that things are not working out, that this person I married is not suitable to me, is not adaptable to me? and things are not working out the way I expected, then you need to learn more this night. And welcome on board, because we are going to hear a lot about this, and we will hear the plan of God. Why did he bring, why did he create a woman and man and brought them together? And I believe this is the reason why marriage was made. And I believe when we learn this, we are going to prosper, and God is going to bless us, and things are going to work for us. God bless you, and God do you good, and continue to inspire you. We are learning, and marriage is not going to remain the same again. You are not going to collapse in your own marriage. Your own marriage is going to stand. You are going to enjoy, and you are going to be happy. The word of God cannot come just for the sake of coming.
Yeah.
There is a reason. So we are here. Once you see us again, I say, we come to encourage you and show you that marriage works. And even yours will work. Ours has worked for 17 years, and we expect it to work to eternity. And we believe God for that. The God who has been with us from the beginning, he shall continue being with us up to the end. Is going. Let us learn together, and we are going to be blessed. I want to invite my wife so that she can pray, and then we begin right away talking about how suitable are you, how complimentary are you when it comes to your marriage relationship. Welcome, my dear.
Amen. Thank you very much. I'm just excited. And my question is, how far are people willing to go when it comes to marriage? How far are you willing to go? And are you ready to pay the price? Marriage is very important. And if you can't pay the price, there are some things that you will miss out. Secondly, you cannot say that I know enough when it comes to marriage. You cannot say that enough for me. You cannot say you have learned enough. If you will enjoy new levels of glory and new levels of being at peace and also enjoying and finding rest, you are supposed to be very willing to learn. You should avail yourself to understand and to gather more information. And this we gather or we get the information from the sources that the Lord has provided for us. And also you can seek God, and God can teach you more. So please, I want to challenge you. This is the time to arise and say, I want to know more. I want to sink deep in God. I want to do a lot of research. I want to avail myself to sacrifice even sometimes my sleep to have time to learn, so that the intended purpose of God concerning marriage will be manifested in my life. God always works with the levels of our knowledge. The level you are or you are in the things of God, those are the levels that God will manifest. But just release something that will not help you, especially if into that level. So kindly, I challenge you couples, I challenge you those that are willing to have families, avail yourself and be very willing to pay the price. I believe what we were writing up yesterday, and of course the recaps that we have received tonight concerning the burnouts, you are still working it out. And one way of working it out is just through prayers, and also applying what the Lord is revealing to you. Please make sure every information that you have, you use it wisely. You use it wisely. And whatever you apply in a wise manner in your life, it will truly help you. And the name of God will be glorified. So tonight, we want to understand something that the Lord already has dropped in our spirit, so that we can share together on how to be suitable, how to be complementary to each other. I know sometimes people reach a level where you begin to doubt even your integrity of choosing you don't even think that you are the right person. But I want to tell you, that wife of yours, that husband of yours, is your best choice. So if you just get revelation and you treat this woman, this man in revelation, you not regret. You see, you have a system. You have a blessed person. It is just only the change of mind, change of attitude. That's why the one says, be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. So when our minds are renewed, we get to know more. Something that is new from God is dropped in our minds, and we are able to conceive what the Lord is releasing. We want to pray. And before we pray, let us know where you are tuned in from. We thank God for what He's doing through this program. Many people, many families, truly, they are being transformed. We are receiving testimonies from all over the face of the earth. Many people from different nations, they are giving testimonies. Most of them, they're asking questions. Others are just, they want to learn until you tell some people, you have to tell them the time, especially in our nation, so that they can just allow you to sleep, and you begin to interact or to answer their questions the following day. So let us know more, or let us hear from you. Let us please know what the Lord is doing through this program. Let us also know where you are tuned in from. And when you tune in, I beseech you, I beg you in the name of Jesus, be a blessing to those that are connected to you. And how can you be a blessing to them? You can call them, you can text them, you can host a watch party and invite them. That's how we are ministering these days. That's how we are reaching out. So you can involve others to the blessing. You can involve others to the source of information. And by doing that, the Lord will just see you as a faithful servant. So kindly, you can host our watch party, and the Lord will bless you. Let us hear what God is doing, and the Lord will be glorified. We want to pray so that we can start this program this night, and we are trusting God that the heavens above us, the heaven above you, will be widely open. And what you have never seen before, may the Lord allow you to see. What you have never heard, what you have never even perceived, may the Lord drop it tonight in Jesus' name. Let us pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you, we bless you. We say you are awesome. You are the omnipresent God, the great I am that I am. The Lord of hosts you are, the King of kings, and the Almighty Father you are. Tonight we say you are wonderful. You are greater than the greatest. You are mightier than the mightiest, O Lord. We honor you with our breath. We honor you with everything that you've given unto us. We submit you. We submit your will. We submit your Holy Spirit in Jesus' mighty name. Father, have your way. Have your way, Lord. Have your way, Holy Ghost. Have your way, Jesus Christ. In the name of the Lord. Oh, we pray that your wisdom will take charge. Your knowledge and understanding that comes from you, Lord, will take over in Jesus' mighty name. We give ourselves have a way. So the Lord, you can do what you are only able to do, because you are God, who is God of all creation. We bless you, and all our iniquities, every transgression, Lord, anything that is not pleasing before your eyes, Lord, we stand to repent our sins and the sins of all families and on the sins of all our viewers, Lord. Forgive us, sanctify us in Jesus' mighty name. Take charge in this program, and we declare other forces are defeated, other powers have no control in the mighty name of Jesus. We decree the blood of the Lamb, the blood of covenant, the blood of Jesus of our lives, of every family, and over every individual who is watching and who will watch. Home God, we give praise to you. Let there be peace in every household. Let the revelation that originates from your throne sit upon our hearts tonight. And Lord, let there be a total transformation in our lives for your glory and for your honor. May you guide us, may you lead us, may you cause us, Lord, to do your will tonight. And it is in Jesus' name we are praying and we are believed. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Thank you again. Bless you. This is Divine Marriage Program Online. We are grateful for what the Lord is doing in our lives, and I believe you're getting blessed. Let us know again where you are tuned in from and what this program is doing unto your marriage life. We are talking about being suitable and also being complementary to your spouse in a marriage relationship. And I want us to go to the Bible and look at some of the things that God has directed or what God has spoken about marriage, so that we will begin to build up from there. Amen. And the Bible says in the book of Genesis, chapter is 2 and verse 18, the Bible says, "Now the Lord said, it is not good," that is, it's not good, it is not sufficient, "that the man should be alone. I will make a helpmate suitable, adapted, complementary for him." So we look at the helpmates that the Lord is describing here,
mm-hmm.
and the ones that are given, so that we get what to where we want to be. Number one, it is suitable.
Yeah.
Then adapted.
Mm-hmm.
And then number three, complementary for him.
Amen.
So the wife that is coming to this man is coming with these qualities. Number one, it is a helpmate. Is the helpmate. Somebody who comes to help.
Yeah.
Not somebody coming to kill. Somebody who is coming
to help.
To help.
Mm-hmm.
So I want every woman to understand, you are in the life of that man, not to kill him, but to help him.
Not to compete with him.
Not to compete with him or try to bring him down, but is to try to bring him up.
Amen.
So what you need to do is try and bring this person up, because you come as an helper. You come to do the helping business. And this helpmate, as you come to help,
mm-hmm.
you must be suitable
mm-hmm.
to this person. You must be adapted to this person, and you must be complementary to this person.
Amen.
So when you come in and you fail to have these qualities, there shall be something else, not marriage. There shall be striving.
Yeah.
And marriage is not supposed to be a ground of striving. It's a place of love. It's a place of connection.
Yeah.
It's a place of blessing.
Amen.
So once you come to that life, and then there is striving,
mm-hmm.
and this is happening in a marriage relationship, then that is not health at all.
Yeah.
Now, God made sure that he has prepared man mm-hmm. before he brought the woman.
Mm-hmm.
And then he said, it is not good for this man. It is not good that this man should be alone. This man that he had prepared, the man in Eden, that means the man who was in the presence of the Lord.
Amen.
The man who has a job, so he gave him work. The man who is able to till or dress. The man who is able to guard or protect. And a man who is able also to teach. Those are five things. You can cast a vision. You can teach. So those qualities
mm-hmm.
are supposed to be a man before the woman comes in. If a woman does meet you away from the presence of God, will be disastrous, because you must be in the presence of God
mm-hmm.
to know how to lead a woman. A husband is supposed to love the wife the way Christ loved the church. So if you have not been with Christ, how will you love the wife? It's not possible.
Yeah.
So you must learn it from Christ. You must receive it from Christ. Mm. And once you receive it and you learn it from the Christ, you are able to take it to the partner.
Mm.
And I pray that every man will desire to spend more of his time with God so that he will be able to lead the wife, to lead the wife in the right manner. Then the man is supposed to be having that quality of a husband that is able to change that woman, to dress, to hand value, to take someone to higher glory.
Amen.
To produce it to the finished product. And value, turn natural into a finished product. And that's the quality of a man. That's why I say always when a man marries, he changes the title, becomes husband. Husband means master and also means a farmer. Someone who is ready to dress. Somebody is ready to lead. Master, you lead. You are a leader. Then a farmer, somebody who is able to earn value, mm-hmm. cultivate,
mm-hmm.
and bring the best. Sow seed, then see harvest. That's a farmer. Take care of crop. And this is what a man is supposed to do.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the woman meets that man in the garden, in the presence of God. Somebody who is having his job. Somebody who is able to till or to cultivate or to earn value. Somebody who is able to protect. And somebody who has a vision. Somebody who has a vision. Who has a word.
Not
an idle man.
Yeah.
Because you are coming to help.
Mm.
What are you coming to do? To yeah. help.
Mm-hmm.
What will you help if the woman is the man is idle? So you will be reduced to idle woman the rest of your life.
Yeah.
And that is not what you were created for.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this woman now is coming to this man. The woman must be an helper to this man. Helper to this man. This woman must be adaptable to this man. This woman must also be suitable. And this woman must be able to complement this man. So this is where now the foundation begins. This is where everything now begins from there. So if the helper fails to be adaptable, fails to be suitable, fails to be complementary, then this man who is given an helper becomes miserable in life. He cannot also function because the helper has come with other things that were not ordained to be brought. So it will be difficult. It will be hard. It will be something that is not good at all.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So we want to look at those things in depth. And we want to look at these things in the eye of the Spirit.
Amen.
So that we will be helping you. Because there are some people who are complaining. I have a lot of stress. My wife, since she came on, my life has been this. The wife says, I am married to a husband who is very lazy. Everything does not move like this and this. And we are miserable. This life is not good. How do we solve this problem? We need to look these things
yeah.
at the eye of the Spirit. Now you can take over, my dear, and help us now. Because today you will talk a lot. Because we are talking about the helper and how we are supposed to move now.
Yeah, I just want to begin with this. The relationship between a husband
mm-hmm.
and a wife.
Yeah.
It is the relationship between Christ
mm-hmm.
and church.
Mm-hmm.
And the way many Christians
mm-hmm.
are frustrating God. There are people who can wonder, can God be frustrated?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, we can frustrate God.
Mm-hmm.
The way we conduct ourselves,
mm-hmm.
the way we do the things of the kingdom,
mm-hmm.
the way we engage ourselves in the kingdom affairs,
mm-hmm.
if we lack revelation,
mm-hmm.
we frustrate God.
Mm-hmm.
Like in the times that we are in right now,
uh-huh.
the bride
mm-hmm.
actually has got a lot of impurities.
Mm-hmm.
And because of those impurities,
uh-huh.
we have become people who cannot function well.
Mm-hmm.
We are not adopting ourselves to the things of the kingdom.
Mm-hmm.
We are not complementing with the Spirit of God.
Mm-hmm.
The same way, if life. Mm-hmm. They are together,
mm-hmm.
and we fail to complement one another.
Mm-hmm.
That kind of marriage will be a marriage full of frustration.
Mm-hmm.
That kind that has no direction.
Mm-hmm.
And if we lack direction in marriage,
mm-hmm.
then we cannot achieve, first of all, mm-hmm. the intended purpose mm-hmm. of God.
Mm-hmm.
Secondly, even mm-hmm. what we met, there are plans, there are some visions that mm-hmm. each couple has.
Mm-hmm.
And if we cannot complement each other,
mm-hmm.
that vision becomes a nightmare.
Mm-hmm.
And that brings a lot of frustration because you don't see the way anymore.
Mm-hmm.
If people cannot complement each other,
mm-hmm.
you cannot see where you are going.
Mm-hmm.
So as I am saying, the way the church is right now, the believers,
mm-hmm.
the kind of believers, most of them,
mm-hmm.
the way they have reached a level, they are no longer praying,
mm-hmm.
they are no longer worshiping,
mm-hmm.
they are no longer committed to the things of the kingdom.
Mm-hmm.
The way God feels frustrated,
mm-hmm.
that's how many husbands are frustrated.
Mm-hmm.
That's how many husbands are frustrated.
Mm-hmm.
Because women, we reach out to God
mm-hmm.
as a church
mm-hmm.
so that what God is having for us,
mm-hmm.
what he has kept for us in store,
mm-hmm.
through the worship, through our commitment,
mm-hmm.
through our submission to him,
mm-hmm.
we can draw that which God has for us.
Uh-huh.
Now, when we complement each other,
mm-hmm.
this is the time now we are able to draw
mm-hmm.
from one another.
Uh-huh.